Greetings. This is video number 5 in the series Comparing Christianity to Islam, and it is the second video examining the self-consistency within Islam and the Quran. What does Islam say about itself? We have already examined the following claims. Islam claims the Quran is another revelation from the God of Abraham. Islam claims the Torah, Psalms, and Bible are the word of its Allah. Islam claims the word of its Allah cannot be changed. What additional claims does Islam make about itself? Islam claims it respects and worships the God of Abraham. But this begs the question. We've already seen the Torah is claimed to be from the same deity. But why didn't Muhammad know the name of the God of Abraham? The Quran claims the name of the deity Abraham followed is Allah, which is literally Arabic for God. But the Bible, specifically the Torah and Tanakh, reveal that the name of the God of Abraham is Yahweh, the Tetragrammaton. Where does the word Yahweh even appear? In the Torah, Yahweh appears over 1,558 times. That means the Torah, the word of Allah, uses the name of God 1,558 times. And not once does it say Allah. In the Hebrew Old Testament, that's the Torah and Tanakh, Yahweh appears in 5,822 verses. Yahweh is almost always translated to the English word Lord. But this begs the question, how could Islam not even know this is God's name? So how is this an inconsistency with Islam and what it says about itself? Well, Islam claims the Torah and Bible are the word of Allah. The Torah and Tanakh reveal the name of God is Yahweh. The Torah calls God Yahweh in 1,558 verses, but Islam and the Quran have no knowledge of this name. How could Islam not even know this? Remember, this is looking at what the Quran says and what Islam says, and judging it for consistency with itself. Islam claims the Torah is the word of Allah, but the Torah says God's name is Yahweh. This is a glaring inconsistency that Islam can't explain. Islam claims you must say Shahada to be Muslim. Anyone calling themselves Muslim can tell you what Shahada is. There is no God but Allah, and his messenger is Muhammad. And Islam claims all prophets from Adam to Jesus were Muslim before Muhammad. But this begs the question. Who did Adam say Shahada to? Who did each prophet say Shahada to? But this begs another question. Who did Muhammad say Shahada to? Did Muhammad say there is no God but Allah and Jesus is his only prophet? But this begs another question. How could anyone before Muhammad, from Adam to Abraham to Moses to Jesus, say Shahada before Muhammad existed? If you must declare Shahada to be Muslim, how could you claim Muhammad was a prophet before he even existed? Does Islam try and explain away this inconsistency? In fact, they do. They will try to claim before Muhammad, people all said the following. There is no God but Allah and prophet was his messenger. Pick your favorite prophet du jour. I've actually heard some in Islam try and claim that before Muhammad, saying Shahada meant claiming the current prophet, or the last prophet, or the most recent prophet. But that begs the following question. If this declaration existed before Muhammad, why is there no record of the Shahada in the Torah or the Bible, or in any written documentation before Muhammad? So this is not consistent with Islam's or the Quran's claims. Islam claims Muhammad was foretold in the Torah and in Injil. Where does Islam make this claim? Surah 7, 157. Those who follow the messenger, the unlettered prophet, whom they find written in what they have of the Torah and the Gospel. Pay attention to that. Whom they find written in what they have of the Torah and the Gospel. Surah 61:6. And when Jesus, the son of Mary, said, O children of Israel, indeed I am the messenger of Allah to you, confirming what came before me of the Torah, and bringing good tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name is Ahmad. But when he came to them with clear evidences, they said, this is obvious magic. So Islam is consistent and repeats the claim that the Bible of Muhammad's day contained mention of Muhammad. But this begs the following question. If the Bible of Muhammad's day, if the Torah of Muhammad's day mentioned him, how, when, where, and by whom were all these references removed? Islam cannot explain this. And in fact, the manuscript evidence calls this claim a fraud. While Islam claims Muhammad was foretold in the Torah and Injil, it has no specific references. So where does Islam attempt to claim Muhammad is mentioned? Deuteronomy 18. But Islam ignores the majority of the prophecy, focusing only on words they can twist to fit Muhammad. So they are inconsistent. They only respect the word or words in the prophecy that they can use, and they don't respect the other words that God used to describe and characterize the prophet. That's not very accurate. Song of Solomon 5:16. Islam claims Muhammad is mentioned by name in a book that Islam calls pornography. That's not very coherent. Isaiah 29:12. But Islam ignores the context of Isaiah 29:13, which condemns the same person mentioned. Not very respectful of the context. And notice, the Quran specifically claims mention in the Torah and in Injil, or the Gospel. But Islam is so desperate, they use any reference they can imagine. Neither Isaiah nor Song of Solomon are in the Torah or the Injil. Does the statement claimed in Surah 61:6 exist as Islam claims? Surah 61:6 says, And when Jesus the son of Mary said, O children of Israel, indeed I am the messenger of Allah to you, confirming what came before me of the Torah, and bringing good tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name is Ahmad. This is supposed to be one long quote of what Jesus said. And if you read the other versions of the Quran, it will say, and remember when. So they're trying to imply you've heard it taught and you know that Jesus said this. But notice the lack of specific reference. And this begs yet another question. Why does Islam look to the Torah and Bible for Muhammad's credentials when Islam calls the Torah and Bible corrupted? Islam is not consistent in general, but Islam is consistent in one point. Islam consistently cites any verse of the Torah or Bible which it feels supports Islam, and consistently rejects every passage of the Torah and Bible which refutes it. Or said another way, Islam only believes Muhammad's Quran. On this point, they are consistent. So is Islam being consistent with itself? No, it is not. Because Islam makes claims about other religions to serve one purpose, then makes other claims to serve ulterior purposes. No. Islam is not consistent. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Clearly, the issue of self-consistency within the Quran and Islam requires more than two videos.